Good morning. In just a few minutes, we'll be asking you to leave the comfort of your classroom and to assemble outside. We'll be asking you to abandon, if you will, your personal concerns and worries. We'll be asking you to change your focus from you and to think about some men and women you don't even know. We will ask you to leave your class quietly and to go outside where it is cold. We'll ask you to listen with your full attention and to reflect seriously on the words you will hear. Why should we do this? You may know the answer already. Once a year, we deliberately turn our attention away from our daily lives to honor those who have stood in defense of our rights and freedoms, and to remember those who have made the ultimate sacrifice so that we may live a life that is the envy of most of the world. The challenge for us is that we weren't there. We didn't go to war and live through what must have been an extremely physical and mental struggle. What would it have been like to live in trenches surrounded by mud and rats, constantly tormented by lice? We can only imagine the horror of living through a bombardment with deafening shells exploding around us. We can only imagine the frustrations of our peacekeepers in Afghanistan trying to rebuild hope in the midst of despair. In reality, we can only imagine the horror of living through war. We can only imagine the pain and personal tragedy that so many have suffered from the War of 1812 to World War I, from World War II to the Korean War, from UN peacekeeping missions to the war in Afghanistan and Libya. I can only imagine what must have gone through my father's head when he served in battle in World War II at the age of 22 years young. He chose to only rarely speak of his experiences as they were too painful to relive. I suspect he was not the only veteran who felt that way. How can we honor those who have given up so much for us, their youth, their health, and their lives? How do we say thank you? It's a debt of gratitude we can never repay. Many of you have written postcards that will be shared with soldiers. Many of you have worked on creating wreaths to be placed outside. Today, you're wearing a poppy which proclaims to the world that you remember and you care. Today you are willing to be slightly uncomfortable as you join the whole school in assembly with one single focus to pay tribute to the men and women in uniform who trundled off to foreign lands on your behalf. This is how we give thanks. We'll forever remember, never forget. In a minute, you'll be watching a short video after which there'll be an announcement inviting you to join together outside. Thank you.
Good morning, shoppers. At 11 o'clock on this 11th day of November, we'd like to invite you to share with us 2 minutes of silence in honor of our veterans.
They fought and some died for their homeland. They fought and some died, now it's our land. Look at his little child, there's no fear in her eyes. Could he not show respect for other dads who have died? Take 2 minutes, would you mind? It's a pittance of time for the boys and the girls who went over. In peace may they rest, may we never forget why they died. It's a pittance of time. God forgive me for wanting to strike him. Give me strength so as not to be like him. My heart pounds in my breast, fingers pressed to my lips, my throat wants to bawl out, my tongue barely resists, but 2 minutes I will bide. It's a pittance of time for the boys and the girls who went over. In peace may they rest, may we never forget why they died. It's a pittance of time. read the letters and poems of the heroes at home. They have casualties, battles, and fears of their own. There's a price to be paid if you go, if you stay. Freedom's fought for and won in numerous ways. Take 2 minutes, would you mind? It's a pittance of time for the boys and the girls all over. May we never forget our young become vets at the end of the line. It's a pittance of time. It takes courage to fight in your own war. It takes courage to fight someone else's war. Our peacekeepers tell of their own living hell. They bring hope to foreign lands that hate mongers can't kill. Take 2 minutes, would you mind? It's a pittance of time for the boys and the girls who go over. In peacetime, our best still don battle dress and lay their lives on the line. It's a pittance of time. In peace may they rest, lest we forget why they died. Take a pittance of time.